Hello, hello, mic test. The net profit is 93.327%. CAGR is 26.01%. A win rate of amazing 90%. Maximum drawdown is in control, which is 10%. Profit factor is 19.61. This is something that we should definitely consider for further analysis. Hello financial programmers, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. If you're here to learn how to make a grid trading strategy, then you're at the right place. This entire playlist is focused on Tradomate.one. Previously, I have made multiple videos on different types of trading strategies in the same platform. Things like RSI divergence, pullback strategy, momentum strategy, EMA plus Doji plus ADX, MACD, EMA, inside bar strategy, and yes, you're wrong about the Bollinger Bands. My last video was on Arun Oscillator. The links of all these videos are in the description section. In this video, I will be using the same platform, which is Tradomate.one. Guys, this is my startup. I started up this company with Yashu and Satyam, and we'll be using its Python bot creator to build the grid trading strategy using simple moving average. Let's see what are the results in the end. On this channel, I turn all my viewers to successful financial programmers. Here I upload videos related to making trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, using some highly valuable finance APIs, and building some great trading strategies like this one. So if you're interested in all of these things, then click on the subscribe button and also turn the bell icon, because there are many more videos that are about to come on this YouTube channel. And I bet you that this one free click is going to increase your skill sets significantly. Before starting to code, guys, a quick disclaimer. Through this video, neither me nor Tradomate.one is giving any trading or investment recommendation. This video is solely made to teach you how to use this particular platform to build some great trading strategies. Please do detailed analysis and research before putting your real money into this particular strategy or any strategies. Perfect. So yes, this is the platform, guys, which is Tradomate.one. The link is in the description section. If you're new to it, click on get started for free. I'm pretty sure most of you guys have already created an account at Tradomate.one. So yes, this is the dashboard. I'll quickly skim through the entire platform. This is the dashboard where I've created all the trading bots. Builder is where I will be making my trading strategy. Docs will redirect you to the detailed documentation of how to use this particular platform. And yes, last but not the least, which is the Discord community. Guys, we call it Tradomate Army. I highly insist you to be a part of this community, because there are many more traders who are doing some great discussion with each other and with the Tradomate team to build some great trading strategies. It's free of cost. So yes, please check it out. Perfect. So let's click on create new bot button. Right now we have exposed the Python bot creator only in the platform. Eventually we'll have the rule-based logic creator and the generative AI strategy builder as well. So yes, please stay tuned to it. Let's click on proceed. These are some of the example strategies that you guys can use to start building your trading strategies. These are no way any recommendation or advice from the platform. So I'll just click on say EMA crossover strategy and click on proceed. Now I need to select the stock that I would be considering for this particular trading strategy. I can select Indian stock, US stock, or even cryptocurrencies. So let's do say Bharti Airtel, right? On the top, you can see the candlesticks chart of Bharti Airtel. This is the ticker, NSE is the exchange, Indian rupee is the currency. This is the interval. So for example, if I click on 4 hours, it will refresh the page to make the 4 hours of the candlesticks chart for Bharti Airtel. On the bottom, you can see the Python code of this strategy, which is EMA crossover strategy. Of course, we will be changing it to make a grid trading strategy. I would like to show you what is a grid trading strategy. So basically, suppose this is the line chart of any particular stock, right? So we make multiple grid lines and we take some buy and sell position on the basis of these grid lines. So suppose in this case, the price is going down. So we are taking multiple buy positions whenever the line is crossing the grid lines, and whenever it goes up, we take the sell position. So if we took a buy position here, we will exit this particular position in the next grid line. So in this case, this one, this buy position is exited in this particular grid line, and so on, right? So this is how we are actually trying to average our position out, and we are just trying to make as much profit as possible on individual orders. So the main idea here is to increase the win rate as much as possible and reduce the maximum drawdown. I'll quickly explain this particular code, guys. So we have exposed our own library called Tradomate. In this particular code, we have all the functionalities which you would be requiring in this particular library. The first function is for the inputs, where you provide all your inputs. Make sure that you are using this exact same syntax, which is config dot and then your input as the inputs that you provide. The second function is where we write our trading strategy, in this case the EMA crossover strategy. Perfect. So I will delete these two things and I'll keep length as 50, because I would like to make the grid lines as straight as possible, as we can see here, right? And here I would change it to SMA is equal to TM dot SMA, and everything else is exactly the same. Let's delete this entire thing, which is basically where we were taking positions. We'll do it later, and I'll change it to SMA, and this one as SMA as well. Let's keep it right. If you run this, we can see a simple SMA line on this particular chart, right? Simple. Now let's do one thing. In order to make grid lines, we'll have to make multiple SMAs, right? And parallel lines, as we can see it here. So for example, this reference line is the SMA that we have drawn. We'll have to make multiple parallel lines above and below it, right? So I'll make an upper and lower band and then define multiple lines parallel to it between them. That's the main motive, right? So in this case, upper band is this, the highest price, and the lower band is this one. So I'll define these two things first and then eventually get all the grid lines between them. For this, I need a few more inputs, which are standard deviation and grid lines. I will have a standard deviation of 8%, and the grid lines, number of grid lines are also 8. Now, so upper band is equal to, or actually I would say upper bound is equal to MA multiply by 1 plus config dot standard deviation. Similar to it, lower bound is MA multiplied by 1 minus standard deviation, which is 8%, right? So we have the upper band and the lower band, which are 8% away from the reference line, which is simple moving average. I'll have to change it to SMA, right? The next thing is the grid width, right? Which is upper bound minus lower bound divided by the number of grid lines, which I'm defining, minus 1. I just need to see how many grid lines will I make between the upper bound and the lower bound. And then we'll make grid array, which is equal to a list. I will have a list of lower bound plus grid width multiply by I. Now this I will be an iteration, so we'll have a for loop here for I in range of config.grid. So we have the entire array between the lower bound and the upper bound, right? Now let's do one thing. I'll comment this. Plot all the things, all the different grid arrays. Perfect. So these are the grid arrays, grid array 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? Because we have total 8 grids. So starting from 0, we have it till 7. I'm giving the title as grid and then the number inside it. I would keep color as blue to all of them except the center one, which is this one, is the center line, which is actually these two are the center lines. Let's keep these two as red and all of the other as blue, and then overlay is equal to true for all of them because we would like to plot it on the same graph. Let's save and run. Again, of course, there will be 0% return and everything because we are not taking any positions as of now. We are just plotting it. Perfect. So here you can see we have built, we have made grid lines of the moving average, right? These two are the main ones, and then we have three grid lines above and three below, right? So if I just zoom it to this particular area, yeah, for example, this is a good area. We will take a buy position here because the price crossed the grid line, this one, right? So we'll take a buy position here. It crossed another grid line, we'll take another buy position here. It crossed another grid line, the third one, we'll take another buy position, and here also I think it's crossing a bit. So we'll take one more long position here. We'll buy more shares here. And then when it goes up, we'll sell this particular order at this area. We'll sell this order here, and so on. If you have any doubt, please listen to this particular segment again, because it is really important for all the positions that we'll be taking. Perfect. So now let's build the entire strategy. The first thing that I'll do here is I'll make another list, which is order array, which is basically a boolean. It will have either true or false inside it. Whenever there is a position on any particular grid line, we'll change that from false to true, otherwise it will always be false. So I'll just keep false 8 times false, because we have total grid size of 8, right? That's one thing. Now secondly, here I'll create entry condition. Now for different grid lines, we'll have to iterate it for all of them. So for I in range config dot grids, you'll see if the data dot close dot I lock minus 1, which is the last close price is less than the grid value of that particular iteration, right? It will start from zero. And the second thing that we need to consider is there is no position, which is and not order array. It should be false. It means there is no position over there. Then we'll enter a long market position where the quantity is config.quantity, which is one, I think. Yeah. And the comment is this thing, which is long, and then I, which is the grid line that we are on. And as I mentioned, we will change the order array of that particular element to true from false. Second is elif data.close.iloc minus one, which is the last close price, is greater than the grid of that iteration, which is I, and the order array of the last grid line is equal to true. As we did not here, not order array, we wanted it to be false. Right now we want it to be true because we are closing the position here in the elif condition. Then we'll get all the positions, which is through using tm.get all open orders. Inside this, these are the order objects. So inside this, I'll just write for order in open orders. I'll see if the order.comment is equal to long and then this one, because we are providing a comment everywhere. So if this if the order.comment is equal to long and then I minus one, which is the last grid line, we will close that particular position, which is using tm.close position, and then order, which is the exact same order. We would like to close the last order only, not other grid lines. Comment is close and then I minus one. And in the end, order array I minus one is again false. And as we found this particular thing, we'll break this particular for loop. So yeah, that's it. I know this is a bit complicated, and of course it requires a lot of attention. I'll quickly go through it again. We are using the same library, which is Tradomate as TM. The first function is for inputs. What are the function? What are the inputs? We have initial capital of 50,000. We have length of 50. The quantity is 1. Let me just increase it to say 10. Standard deviation is 8%. Standard deviation is basically to make the upper and the lower band. Number of grid lines, 8. We have started with making an order array, which is having only false and it's a list. And then this is where we are building our trading strategy. We started with the SMA. We calculated the upper band and the lower band. We calculated the width by just dividing the spread with the number of grid lines minus one. And then we built the entire array between the upper and the lower bound. In the end, for the entry condition, we are iterating all the grid lines one by one. So for loop, for that, we are taking a condition of when the last price is less than the last grid value and there is no, I would say, true value in the order array, which is basically there is no position already. And in that case, we'll enter a market position, which is long position market. Quantity is quantity.qty, and this is the comment. We will change the order array, of that particular element to true. Then elif, if the last price is more than this particular thing, and there is an order in the last grid, and in that case, we will have to close that particular position. So we will take all the position using this particular function, which is tm.getAllOpenOrders. In the end, we are using one more for loop to understand which particular order to close through the comments. So order.comment is this thing. If this thing satisfies, then we'll close this particular order, and we are commenting close I minus one, making the order array of that particular element again false. That's the entire logic behind this code. Let me just run it. Let's see what are the results. This code will take some time to run, guys, because it's a bit more complicated. We have multiple for loops here, so it's absolutely fine. Let's just wait for some time. Okay, so we have made some error here, which is QTY. Okay, got it. I think this was quantity. It's my bad. I'll change it to quantity. Let's see. So yes, that's how we make a great trading strategy, guys. The net profit is 93.327%. CAGR is 26.01%. A win rate of amazing 90%. Maximum drawdown is in control, which is 10%. The profit factor is 19.61. And we are taking total 80 trades in this particular trading strategy historically in the last 2000 candles. So yeah, this is something that we should definitely consider for further analysis. If you have missed anything in this particular code, guys, it's absolutely fine. The link is in the description section. Just click on that link and copy and paste it. So yes, guys, before leaving, if you liked even one thing about this video, please click on the like button because it really helps with the algorithm. Also, click on the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon because there are many more videos that are coming on this YouTube channel. And I am pretty sure that you would learn a lot watching my YouTube videos. The next video is a big surprise. So yes, please stay tuned to it. Let me know in the comment section, what do you expect from the next video? I'm very excited for it. And yes, guys, last but not the least, please check out the Discord server and start engaging with the other traders and build a great community out there. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and over there you'll see this entire playlist of Tradomate.one, and over there you'll see this walkthrough video of Tradomate.one. So yes, guys, keep learning, keep financial programming, and I'll see you in the next video very, very soon. Until then, peace.